to at last. I do hope you had a good journey. It was very unpleasant. I never enjoy travel. You must be poor George's wife.
Yes.
Your flowerbeds are disgracefully untouched. Take my advice. Plant evergreens. Or better still, have nothing to plant at all. Just a plain symmetrical plant.
But dear Miss Andrew, I am so fond of flowers.
Then you are a very silly woman. Where did George go?
He had an urgent appointment, which no doubt he was late for, as usual.
It's not much of a house, is it?
Well, we like it.
Then it doesn't take a lot of you. Look at that dust! There! There! Filth!
Well, you're rather short-staffed at the moment.
Hasn't anyone ever cleaned those curtains?
Now, wait just a minute.
Oh, you must be the children. Pity. I don't suppose you know who I am.
Yes, we do. You're the Holy Terror.
Yes, you're
the
boy. You're Jane, I suppose. Why aren't you wearing stockings?
I don't like them.
Tut, what manners? We haven't a minute to lose. These children haven't spoiled.
I've arrived here just in time. By chance I've run that countryman that must be Brimstone and Treacle, father of blue, emerald doses of passion. He got the truth, children we call, the lesson I'm going to teach you. Just follow my model and gentlemanly cuttle, it may be irksome to them. So seek satisfaction from punitive action. Brimstone and Treacle.
Wipe off the snow.